Good day students, today we'll be studying about a tutorial problem number 2 in FAR filter design using frequency sampling technique. So here, determine the filter coefficients of a linear phase FAR filter of length n equal to 15 which has a symmetric unit sample response and a frequency that satisfies the following condition: h of 2 pi k divided by 15 equal to 1 for k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 0.4 for k equal to 4 and 0 for k equal to 5, 6, 7. It's very important to understand the difference between this problem and the previous problem. In the previous problem, the frequency response we had to find, and from that we had to find the sampled frequency response. But here in this problem, directly the sampled frequency response itself is given. So step number 1 is not needed over here since the sampled frequency response is itself given. Just looking into this filter characteristic itself states that it is a low pass filter because it exists, the values of this, the magnitude exists only for k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 4. For higher values it is 0. So obviously it is a low pass filter. So directly we move on into step number 4 where already by frequency sampling h of k has been obtained. So that obtained h of k value is given over here, right? That too, the magnitude of the sampled value is given as 1.5 and 0. So it is given, and we know that from the magnitude we can find what is the h of k. So h of k is e power minus j alpha 2 pi k by n at k equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. So n equal to 15, alpha will obviously be equal to 7. So h of k, which involves both the magnitude as well as phase, is given as, in the place of 1 we can write it as e power minus j alpha into 2 pi k divided by n. So substituting for value of alpha 7, we get 14 pi k by 15 for k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. Similarly, for k equal to 4, it is the magnitude 0.4 multiplied by e power minus j alpha 14 pi k by 15, and it is 0 for k equal to 5, 6, 7. Hence, this is the h of k which is obtained. So, based on this h of k, we need to identify these values of h of k which are needed in our next calculations. So, for each value of k, for k equal to 0, we just substitute over here and find the h of 0. For k equal to 1, we find h of 1. For k equal to 2, k equal to 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. We have just obtained the values of h of k which will be useful in calculating our h of n. So now we have to plot as usual the values of k. It's for an understanding. So this omega plane is divided into 15 samples and we know that the center of symmetry here is 7 for this filter. And we note from 0, 1, 2, 3, the value is 4 and the value is 1. And for k equal to 4, it is 0.5. It is symmetrical and hence the same repeats here till 14. As we have seen already, it is enough to consider the samples from 0 to 7 since we are taking a symmetrical FAR filter. So we need to find the impulse response. So h of k, take IDFT h of n, here n equal to 15. So choose the filter equation appropriately. We can see that it includes k equal to 0, k equal to 1, up to k equal to 7. So it is taken over here. We know that here k equal to 1 to 7, we have the values here as k equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and a different value for 4, and for 5, 6, 7 it is 0. So using that, we can see that h of 0 plus 2 into from k equal to 1 to 3, we take it as real part of this. Next, for k equal to 4, it's a different value of h of k. So we are splitting the summation for k equal to 4. And then for 5 to 7. So obviously we know that from 5 to 7, this term will become 0. So 1 by 15 plus 1 by 2, k equal to 1 to 3, h of k value is given as e power minus j 7. It is nothing but what? E power minus j alpha into omega. So 7 into omega. So 4, you can see that h of k value. For k equal to 4 is nothing but from the tabular column itself you can see for k equal to 4 it is nothing but 0.4 into e power minus j 14 pi k by 15. So we should be careful in choosing these values. So 0.5 e power minus j 56 pi by 15 e power minus jk 2 pi by n. So this term will go to 0. Now 1 by 15 to k equal to 1 to 3. So this can be written as, so you can take n minus 7 as common over here, right? So and the 2 pi k by 15 into n minus 7 will be taken. A real part of that is nothing but cos. And similarly 0.4 e power j, you can take 8 pi by 15 as common and you will be getting n minus 7, and the real part of this is nothing but cos of 8 pi by 15 into n minus 7. So here we have k is equal to 4. So when k is equal to 4, obviously this will become 8 pi. So here actually instead of 2 pi k n, you can simply write it as 8 pi n. So this 8 pi n only, when you take it as common, you'll be getting it as 8 pi by 15 into n minus 7. So a careful simplification of this will give you what is the value of h of n. So from this h of n, you can apply the symmetric property and find out the filter coefficients. So h of 0 will be equal to h of 14. Choose the value of pi as 180 degrees and not as 3.14. And obtain the values. For h of 7, you will have a separate value since it is symmetrical. This, as explained in the previous example, the transfer function is realized and then apply symmetric, group the terms accordingly, substitute the values of h of 0, h of 1 and find h of z. Finally, the linear phase FAR filter structure realization is obtained. So here we have 14 delays as per our equation, and if you have 14 delays, then we need to put 7 delays on the top and 7 delays on the bottom. Take the tapping of the filter appropriately so that you get your y of z. Tap the filter at the required points, multiply it by the filter coefficients, add the tapped values and obtain y of z. Thank you, students. Thank you.